If you're in, you want to embed it to take the floor.
Madam Speaker, it is indeed an honor for me to address this August House after the 51st election week and my appointment as the Minister of Health and Medical Services. I wish to thank His Excellency the President for his most gracious address. I also want to join all the honorable members who have spoken before me in congratulating you for being the Speaker of this noble House for a second consecutive term. You carry a purpose, and that purpose is obviously for your current position as Speaker of the elected Parliament of Fiji. You're also a role model for all health professionals. I'd like to congratulate the Prime Minister of Fiji and the leader of the Fiji First Party, Honorable Rear Admiral Retired Wrenga Bainimarama, and I'm very confident of his leadership and vision for a better Fiji for all. His untiring commitment and dedication to the needs of our nation and the faith shown by the people of Fiji on his leadership has seen the return of the Fiji First back to government. I also congratulate and thank the Acting Prime Minister for his hard work, perseverance, and faith in all of us, including me. Madam Speaker, I also congratulate all Cabinet Ministers and Assistant Ministers. I congratulate the Opposition Leader and all the Parliamentarians. I wish to give special recognition to all our female Members of Parliament. You are a source of inspiration to all girls and women who are there in the community. Madam Speaker, I congratulate and thank the Fiji First Office executives, supporters, and volunteers because they laid the platform for our success. Madam Speaker, there are two Bible verses that always remind me of the greatness of God. Psalms 24:1, the earth is the Lord's and everything therein. And the second is John 3:16, for God so loved the world that he gave his only son that whosoever believeth in him will not perish but have everlasting life. These Bible verses remind me of the beginnings and the love of God and the grace of God that has brought me to this August House. My relations realistically cover a significant portion of our great land. My mother's heritage is Bemana in Namosa, and she was raised by the Druavesi family in Tadinovo. Her mother is from Saukasa Teleru, and my father is from Moala, a small village in the bay called Ketira. My grandmother is from Matuka in Laut, and with all our ones in Suwa, my father went to primary school, secondary school, and worked his way directly to Fiji Institute of Technology and took himself to Australia to further his studies in engineering. My mother was raised by her stepfather, Master Nemani Ndrobesi, until her maturity when she rejoined her father's family and her heritage with the Twindom Tukia, the Kolikoli family of Bemana. So my family are the Nyulewu and Keresoni of the Tuimwala clan, the Wangai Ratu of the Tuinasau clan of Naroi Mwala Lau, the Wanganimbete, Wangari Sau, Hul and Lendo families of Ketira, the Ramasi of Murewa in Matuku, the Twindom Tukia, the Kolikoli family of Bemana, Nabosa, the Twimbara, the Ndrobesi family of Northern Rewa, the Twinaro and Rungulelebu family of Saukasa Teliebu, and my extended relations include the Twindom Tukia Wai, Winibalu Korolebu in Gunimbau, Nakabu in Nandi, Ba, Raki Raki, Visese, and many, many more. I realize, Madam Speaker, that I stand on the platform of the dreams that my forefathers have dreamt of in terms of forging the way forward through education and hard work. In my early childhood, I went to numerous schools, Delanemas Government School in Raimba, Lelin Memorial in Natambua, Lambasa College, Nisimu Secondary, and I spent a year in university before going on to medical school. We traveled a lot when I was a child because my father was an engineer with Public Works and my mom was a teacher. And as a child, Madam Speaker, growing up in different towns, I came to appreciate our beloved country. And the experience gave me the urge to serve the people and also be in a position where I could be able to advocate for learning and serving. Madam Speaker, growing up in Witulebu, I also came to fully appreciate the meaning of equality. My mom is from Witulebu, so when we have large ceremonial functions, I can see that my mother is always very sure what to do and who to engage to have a successful event. My father, on the other hand, because he came from Lau, I always sensed that at times he was uncertain of himself and possibly insecure. I recognized that even within our Itoke community, there are levels of inequality that I could say existed then and probably still exists. I fortunately did not have those feelings that my dad had because I felt belonged because my mother is from Witulebu. As I look back now, my faith and resolve towards equality for everyone, forged by my childhood experiences, has only been made stronger. It is my sincere wish that no Fijian should ever feel alienated or foreign in this land. The provisions of the 2013 Constitution safeguards and protects the ownership and customary rights of the Itoke on their land, my mother's people and my father's people. The Constitution also provides the fair opportunity for all Fijians to belong and to acquire and own land and properties in a transparent and equitable manner as and when they choose. Madam Speaker, our Itoke way of life remains the same, and our respect for our chiefs continue. The changes and erosions of our ways cannot be blamed solely on the government or the Constitution, but the lack of training and mentoring and apprenticeship of our young people in our ways. I, for one, will attest to this, Madam Speaker. Of course, when I was a young doctor, and even until now, most times I do not spend time at home. So my children, they grow up learning their mother's dialect of Nakoro Sule, Naitasiri. And so they are Mualans who speak Naitasiri language. Whereas for I grew up in the Mualan customs. I had to make Lowa and Galu. And so I can see the disconnect already within my own family. There must be, Madam Speaker, a separation of family and abuse responsibilities in sharing and championing our culture and the work of the state to support that work. Madam Speaker, during my campaigns, I was faced with questions stemming from lies that were given to them by opposition parties. And as the last maiden speech, Madam Speaker, I want to set it straight. Number one, Kanawu is not sold and never will be sold. Number two, Itoke land remains Itoke land. And incompetence in government institutions that deal with Itoke land will not be tolerated by this government and will deal with these issues definitively. Number three, Fiji's debt burden is small and manageable compared to many other nations, including some first world countries. Number four, the 20 cents plastic levy is not given to the Prime Minister or the Attorney General, but actually is placed in government coffers for development. Number five, the secular state means the state is neutral, Madam Speaker. Apart from other religions, small churches like the one I worship in have the freedom and the right to worship and cannot be discriminated or marginalized. In the same way, churches celebrate their Sabbath on Saturday and some on Sunday. This is protected by the Constitution. Madam Speaker, I have worked as a medical practitioner for 20 years. 12 of those as a qualified surgeon. I have been trained in Fiji, and 3.5 years of my training have been in New Zealand, 3.5 in Palmerston North and Christchurch. The last 4 years, I've also had the pleasure of being associate professor of surgery at the Fiji National University. My students, Madam Speaker, either undergraduate or postgraduate, are the greatest examples to me of a united Fiji. Madam Speaker, I want to pay tribute this afternoon to all health professionals. They are heroes in their own right. Occasionally, they endure adverse publicity. I am proud to say that I cherish the brotherhood and sisterhood of the medical and health profession. Madam Speaker, I am greatly honored to have been given the health and medical services portfolio, one of the most, if not the most important in government, as health is wealth. I'm equally excited as well as challenged when I look at the Ministry of Health and Medical Services annual budget for the financial year 2018-2019, which is 334.9 million, an increase of 13.9 million from the last financial year. Madam Speaker, we have witnessed some remarkable achievements of this government in the health sector. There has been notable progress with the delivery of health services in terms of efficiency, accessibility, equitability, quality and affordability. Madam Speaker, Fiji has made significant progress in improving health outcomes for our people. Maternal and infant mortality rates have declined. Primary health care is well established, with major improvements in secondary health care. Substantial investments have been made in the construction and upgrading of hospitals, health centers, and nursing stations. Medical services have been decentralized to ensure convenience and easy access for the communities. And I've been part of CWM, where we've been providing outreach services, not only us, but Notoka Hospital, also Lambasa, going out into the communities, Tabiuni, for example, Katabu, up in the Lau Group, all over Fiji, providing the service that's available in the main hospitals into all these areas. This is the work of this government. Medical services have been decentralized. The doctor-to-patient ratio is improving, and funding for supply of essential drugs and consumables have been increased. All health facilities will be equipped with modern state-of-the-art technology and equipment to support the delivery of healthcare. Madam Speaker, we have entered into a public-private partnership to develop, upgrade, equip, and operate the Mbai-Lotok hospitals to raise the quality of health services to meet full international standards without extra cost to Fijians. Madam Speaker, from the Waso Delpa campaign, no one would be surprised by what they say to get ahead at this point. So while I wasn't shocked, I was still appalled to hear the opposition talk about the public-private partnership is a plan for government that's been planned by government alongside Australia-based Aspen Medical, claiming it as some kind of international debt trap that would increase poverty. And just yesterday, the Honourable Attorney General pointed out that rumours spread before the elections were far worse. That a visit to one of these newly renovated state-of-the-art hospitals in Mbai-Lotoka would result in a deadly injection from the Chinese. I would laugh at something so ridiculous, but I can't find humour in anything that threatens the health of our people. Let me speak for a moment, not as a Member of Parliament, Madam Speaker, but as a doctor. The health of Fijians should be about cheap political tricks and dirty lies. The confusion spread by the opposition may win the votes, but the paranoia they show about the PPP is dangerous like a disease. Make no mistake, if a patient thinks twice about visiting one of these innovative new medical facilities because of the fear instilled by the opposition, it could literally cost them their lives. As representatives of the Fijian people, we need to rise above the fear-mongering of their health and the health of our nation. Madam Speaker, the truth is this. The public-private partnership will come at no additional cost to the patient or the Fiji taxpayer and will incur absolutely no debt to government. That's the way these partnerships work. In fact, it's just the opposite. The project has leveraged local investment from FNPF and foreign investment from private sector to construct and equip the facilities. This will actually free up taxpayer funds to be invested in other priorities in the health sector and elsewhere. Fiji, Madam Speaker, will have access to world-class modern facilities with more comfortable treatment. You will have access to innovative treatments like 24 hours a day, 7 days a week heart surgery. For the very first time in Fijian history, essential healthcare workers at the hospitals will have access to new training opportunities with new equipment and a better working environment. And hundreds of thousands of Fijian mothers, fathers, grandparents, children, and newborns will stand to benefit. Madam Speaker, we'll be looking at accessibility and affordability of medical care through incentives for private GPs and improving the free medicine scheme. Madam Speaker, let me assure our partners that we will not implement these initiatives in isolation. We will consult with all stakeholders and collaborate with them to ensure that everyone is on the same page to achieving universal health coverage. Madam Speaker, we remain committed to continue to improve healthcare for our mothers and children. We're not forgetting all sectors of the community, upgrading maternity services like in Makoi Maternity Unit, which is delivering a high quality, low risk, developing a delivery service in a highly populated area in Fiji. Work has already begun on the new extension at CWM Hospital that will house 200 new beds in a facility that will develop a complete package of coordinated care specifically designed for women. This will be the first of its kind anywhere in Fiji and built to international standards. New subdivision hospitals will be constructed. Existing ones will be upgraded. These include the upgrading of Balelewa Health Centre and the completion of my mother's hospital, Nabosa Subdivisional Hospital. Health centres will be built in new areas and the upgrading of the Lambasa Hospital. Madam Speaker, I will take the lead role in tackling NCDs in the country, adopting a multi-sectoral approach through better health education, production and adequate supply of fresh fruits and vegetables. There will be greater collaboration and partnership with the private sector, NGOs and development partners. Madam Speaker, as the newly appointed Minister for Health and Medical Services, I am aware of the great expectations the people of Fiji have on the ministry, and I pledge them absolute commitment to improve health services delivery in Fiji for all Fijians. Madam Speaker, I have already laid down the challenge to all staff in the ministry for hard work, dedication and professionalism in all that they do to give all Fijians the best service possible. Madam Speaker, I worship in a small Pentecostal church, and I thank my senior pastor, Toto Joe Tamani, for praying for the will of God before elections. Madam Speaker, with all due respect, Honorable Wesley Mbolo's wife, good wife who is here, and my family, we worship in this church. And we do so with pride because it is protected under the 2013 Constitution. Yeah. It is a small church but cannot be marginalized.
Please.
All along, Madam Speaker, our senior pastor never preached or prophesied which party will win. All he would say is, Honorable Wesley Mbolo, Dr. Wangene Mbete, they are standing for the election. Let's pray for them so they will have seats. We have seats. Let's pray for them that God's will happen.
Yeah.
Madam Speaker, there have been many prophecies. There have been many visions. Many have prayed, but God has answered all the prayer. The makeup of this August house is the answer to God's prayer. God has declared his will, Madam Speaker. And the will of God is for us to govern and for SADC and NFP to stand on the other side. Madam Speaker, I would like to thank my supporters and voters. My relatives of Bemana, my island of Mwala, Goya Village, and one of the other villages of Rasali and Akinda, Wembalawe and Akorosule, my many students and their families, my patients and their families, my colleagues, the hardworking doctors of Fiji, and most of all, Madam Speaker, my family. Miriamma is my wife and she's here. She's a true Koivolo from Nabuda and Akorosule, a warrior at heart. My children, Rokutukana Tale, Roksau and Banibalu. I also like to thank my family, my late mother, my father, Nene Mbo, my siblings, Senibel, Senilambalevadian family, Vilmoni, Roxindrawa, Angume Mbola and Paula, and shout out to my youngest brother. My father-in-law, who's here today, is a Matilek of Nobudu and Nakorosule. Mr. Melisson Nagonoko campaigned for me in the Nongoni Dolitikina. As a father-in-law and a Mbati, he respected my decision, even though he was a SODELPA diehard before, and wholeheartedly supported our Fiji First Party. Madam Speaker, I hope in the next elections, he and Honorable Ngawoka, where is he, will be the two proud father-in-laws campaigning and sitting on this side. Madam Speaker, any prayerful Christian must accept the will of God. And Fiji First carries not only the voters' mandate, but the mandate of God to govern. They all must accept God's will. Madam Speaker, our daughter two months ago, with all due respect, gave us our greatest gift, the birth of our first grandchild. And Miriam Alessieli and the Wangene Mbete is a Fijian who's part European, part Rotuman, and part Itoke, with heritage from right across our multi-ethnic and diverse population. During the campaign, Madam Speaker, I was branded as a traitor. The same words were used in this parliament yesterday, Madam Speaker. I was branded as a traitor. When we talk about relationships, Madam Speaker, when we talk about relationships, this is me. I am from Tobata. My mother's from Burumbasanga. I am married to Kumbuna. When we talk about land, this is me. I have land in Tobata, in Mwala. I have land in my mother's village of Nabosa. And already my wife is planting and we are thinking of leasing land up in Itasin. So I have land in Tobata, Burumbasanga, and also in Kumbuna. So when we talk about Itoke, I'm the Itoke of the Itoke. When we talk about service, I serve. When people are still sleeping, I'm awake. I don't only talk, I go and touch them. Look after them. Take them to theater, wherever, that I need to be able to provide that service. To be branded a traitor, Madam Speaker, was very difficult for me to accept. My son, who's 6'4", as dark as night, was told in New Zealand that he's a son of a traitor. I cannot do that, Madam Speaker. Madam Speaker, even though I'm an Itoke of an Itoke, I'm first and foremost a Fijian.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And because of Miriamma, who has multiple heritage, I will champion equality. God bless you, Madam Speaker. God bless all the honorable members. And God bless Fiji.
Yeah.